In my course, Speaking R, the Language of Data Science, we have the Poisson football model, which we've often seen in action on this channel. We begin with setting up R, which is the king of stats and data science, and free, getting and setting things up so that we're good to go. Next, we look at R and how similar it is to other languages, so that we can use what we already know without starting from scratch. Looking at how for loops are done, conditional statements, as well as functions. With these, we can get to work with R and do what we want with it. R's powerful data types let us work with complex collections of data with ease, which was something new to me coming from a scientific numerical background. We develop a toolkit of commands to work with data, with multiple examples. Now we get to statistics, which is what R is all about. Our example being football and goals scored, which we model with the Poisson distribution. We see where we can get the statistics that we need online to feed into our program, telling it the average number of goals conceded and scored, with which it can simulate many games. From this collection of many games, we can see how often the various outcomes occurred, the probabilities, how often the home team won, lost, or drew, how often three or more goals were scored, or both teams scored. We have the code used, which we can download, and we've seen how R works, how functions are written, for loops work, and so on, which means we can modify the program to tell us what we want. This is a football model, so the basic structure of simulating something with a model many times to generate probabilities of outcomes can be, and is used for all kinds of things, and is known as Monte Carlo simulations. For example, climate models. We look at some examples of R's incredible visualization power, which is the best out there, with a wide range of parameters, allowing us to better represent our rich datasets graphically, to help make sense of them. R is over 15,000 packages, and a massive community, where it's easy to get help if required, which means that we can operate at a very high level, since others have done the hard work. Nobody uses more than a tiny fraction of what's out there. We just need to have R, know how to use it, and get the packages which do what we want to do for us. We just need a few lines of code to call the tried and tested state-of-the-art functions. But in order to be able to use this resource, we need to be able to speak R. There's a link in the description below this video to get access to this course, which is an affiliate link which will help support the channel.